Ja, herzlich willkommen zu einer neuen Ausgabe vom SE Talk. Wie ich schon gesagt habe, bin ich jetzt in Vancouver und habe eine Reihe von Meetings, unter anderem mit StarCore. Neben mir ist Robert Eady, er ist CEO von StarCore International Mines. Und wir haben StarCore erst vor kurzem im Fokus gehabt, weil erstens mal haben sie Dividende ausgeschüttet, zweitens haben sie American Consolidated übernommen oder sind gerade dabei im Prozess und es haben sich daraus einige Fragen ergeben. Robert, thank you to have time for me for a quick update on your company. And we have a lot of great news in the last 2 or 3 months, except the market. The market is at the moment not really in the best shape, as well as gold, but your company doing really well. First, congratulations to this, and second, you're coming up with really some unusual things. First is the dividend. And some subscriber asked me, is this possible that the company will do this on the yearly basis, or is this only a single event that you spend, dividend 1.2 cents?
2 cents.
2 cents.
Yeah. 2 cents per share, which works out of the current share price about a 12% yield.
Yeah, 12% yield.
It is the management's intention to pay it on a yearly basis, and it is our desire to pay it on a yearly basis. If you follow the company and you go back over news releases and interviews, I've always said I wanted to keep $5 million in the bank, and that's my threshold or my comfort level.
Yeah.
So when we started the dividend and the share buyback and then the acquisition, if you add that up, it's less than $5 million, so we still have $5 million in the bank, and we're still cash flow positive from the mine. And development at the mine is going along well. Production, we are up in production again this year. It'll stay at these levels is our goal, and so we'll keep generating cash. So I expect to be able to generate enough cash by next year to be able to pay the dividend again.
That was the first introduction to your company. There was one shows a few years ago. You have this advertisement, you're running around with a shack. And say, we are dividend paying company. It was really a funny thing, and that was, I get the first introduction to your company. Coming to the gold price is at the moment really low. Which gold price you must have that you can going forward with the dividend? So is there a level that you say, okay, now we have really coming or we're cash flow evil with the production?
Oh, 950.
950, okay.
950, 900 in there. We would obviously adjust what our operations are doing to make sure that we generate enough money from the dividend or for the dividend next year. But it's $3 million for us. So we feel that that's an attainable goal.
Okay. Second part of the last few releases was also that you acquired a company called American Consolidated. So how is the process going forward, and what was the reason for the takeover, the merger?
The reason, the process going forward is going well. It's up to the management of AJC to accept the offer, and then their shareholders will vote on it in late November, and then we would be able to make the merger happen. We looked at AJC. I was one of the founders of the company. It went through a series of different management. I'm very familiar with the history of the company, and I saw the company, it being an advantage for StarCore to take the company over, to use the assets in that company to build the assets of StarCore.
Mm-hmm.
If it's going to cost us, say $1.3 million, partly in shares, 3.9% of StarCore, and I can turn that into $4 or $5 million, I will do that over and over again to create value for shareholders.
Mm-hmm.
It's got three different properties in it, and the three different properties have got three different owners, is what our intention is. We have a technical team which is evaluating all the properties, and we'll have to wait for the merger. I've operated the company the last 10 years, it's nothing radical. Mm-hmm. I don't take radical moves. It's a little bit conservative, and I'm looking out in the following years how that I can develop the company on behalf of shareholders. and that's where we're still at. If we can acquire other companies and it makes business sense for us, makes technical sense, then we'll make those acquisitions in the best way possible. We are established in Mexico. We have a lot of experience there, and we think that there's a lot of opportunity.
Okay, this for Starco, it's working well. You're cash flow positive. You will pay the dividend on a yearly basis. You take this merger, and I'm quite sure you're looking for other opportunities. Then you are cash flow positive. You have the opportunity to buy some new mines and so on. But you are also working in overbrand iMining, and there is one company like Cortez. And I get also question about from my subscribers. They say, hey, yeah, they have the Cortez also in their group, and Cortez is now on a major step forward. And is this also a possible merger candidate for Starco?
Any company is a possible merger candidate, but what I have to do with Starco is to stay with the business model which I described to the management team and the board of directors.
Mm-hmm.
And that business strategy is to acquire companies where that we have advantages over, distinct advantages. And Cortez, is it in that category right now? No. Could it be in that category? Yes. But there's another 8 companies,
mm-hmm,
that I'm aware of, that I'm tracking, that I'm looking, mm-hmm, at. And so all the numbers and the technical aspects, mm-hmm, of the company all have to line up,
mm-hmm,
into a certain way. And it's actually not that easy to find.
No. But especially this market condition is, I think it's the best market phase that you can look for new opportunities. Then normally the company is running out of money and you have no really access to get new money from the market.
Yeah, so it is a good period in time to look for those opportunities.
Yeah.
I hope that we do make acquisitions. I don't have one today, new one, but I hope that there is more.
Okay.
Absolutely.
Robert, thank you for your update. Good luck in the future, and wait for the next dividend.
Yes.
And thank you for your time. Also, wie er schon gesagt hat, Dividende ist also jährlich geplant. Es ist auch so, dass der Merger für ihn Sinn macht, weil er halt ein paar Millionen damit verdienen kann, mit den Projekten, die dementsprechend da sind. Und er sucht natürlich weitere Akquisitionen, da ist das Marktumfeld natürlich das Beste, weil die Companies eigentlich oder viele Unternehmen keine Möglichkeit haben, momentan Geld zu raisen am Markt, und sie das dementsprechend auch anbieten können den Companies, und so kann man auch billig sozusagen neue Unternehmen erwerben. Das war's von meiner Seite, und wir sehen uns in Kürze wieder. Tschüss!